Click here to subscribe our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon to get regular updates of our videos. Hello friends, good afternoon to all of you. So I'm back with another video on Sociology Optional subject for UPSC CSE mains examination. At present we are covering the topic of Dimension of Social Stratification under Stratification and Mobility, and we have already finished class and status group. In this video we are going to cover gender, ethnicity and race. That's what is part 2. So friend, please do these triads. It will really motivate me to continue this awesome course. Share as much as possible so that more and more people will get benefited. Comment and like the video and ask any doubt if you have. And now you can also follow us on our page, that is facebook.com/unorthodoxacademy. So friend, as you know that we are covering slot 3, stratification, caste and class. So at present we are at paper 1. We have covered the concepts of stratification mobility, theories of social stratifications, and at present we are continuing with dimensions, and by this video we are also going to finish the dimension. Then the next topic is social mobility. So in this video first we see the gender. So basically sex and gender are two identical terms which are used oftenly interchangeably, but both are different terms because sex is a biological phenomena which is determined on the basis of reproductive organs of an individual, whereas gender is socio-cultural expression of sex. So it is largely determined by the cultural perceptions of the society. Hence males and females are sexes, whereas men and women are genders. So sex and gender now use interchangeably, but gender is purely a cultural perceptions which determines the hierarchy in the social order. Since almost all part of the world is patriarchal, except there are some tribes which are not patriarchal, and these are Garo, Khasi, Nayar in India and Veda in Sri Lanka and etc. So the stratification is determined on the basis of the gender, in which man is the superordinate whereas woman is subordinate, and accordingly they enjoy privileges and disadvantages. So it is believed that since male is biological superior, it reflects in the hierarchy also, but modern researchers prove that biologically some ways female is superior than male. For example, man is superior because the muscle of men are more developed than the female. Secondly, the size of lung, heart and liver are bigger than female. So these two makes males superior than females. So whereas on the other hand females are superior than males in the following term, that is life expectancy of female biologically is more than male. Females speak earlier than males and also learn walking earlier than males. Females have better oratory skills than the males. So hence we can say that biologically yardstick, it cannot be proved that males are superior. So Margaret Mead in her book Sex and Temperament in Three Primitive Societies studied three primitive communities, that is Zuni, Arapesh and Shambuli, and found different form of personality. So basically in Zuni both male and females were Apollonian means cool, calm, peace loving, cooperative personality, whereas in Arapesh both males and females were Dionysian personality, which means they are jealous, competitive, violent, aggressive. And in Shambhuli, contrary to general perceptions, males were Apollonian, that means they are cool, calm, peace-loving, whereas females were Dionysian, that means they are jealous, competitive, violent and aggressive. So there were many studies conducted in different societies, and almost it is believed that the gender inequality is based on cultural prejudices than the scientific fact. So before industrial and French revolution, except few exceptions, societies were largely patriarchal, in which men was at the advantageous positions, whereas females are subject to various disadvantages politically, culturally and socially. So basically there are two phenomena which led to the change in the status of women, initially in Europe and later worldwide. So these two phenomena are industrial and French revolution, and the second one is two world wars, that means World War First and Second. So industrial and French revolutions, first we see an industrial and French revolution basically create an economic environment where women emerge as major working force, First time they came out of the four walls of the house, and they realized their potential, which lead to the self-believing among them. Whereas French Revolution entrusted the ideology of equality among them, which inspired them to mobilize for the cause of equality, which simultaneously gave birth to feminist movement in Europe. Then we see the two world wars. So these two wars changed the demographic profile of Europe, where the loss of male young population due to war gave the opportunity to women to take the responsibilities which traditionally belonged to men. So this further led to the realization of potential among the women, who started challenging male dominance over them. So hence, after these two phenomena, the status of women started changing in Europe, and as other countries and subcontinents became the colony of Europe, this culture diffused to other societies too. So, but again, it is a wrong perception that women in American or European societies enjoy equality, whereas traditional or Asian societies do not. So even in American societies, the gender inequality still prevails. In a study on American society by Timms and Finn, it was found that women prefer relatively easier jobs, which are popularly known as women jobs, and women are 90% in jobs like typing, front office employee, steno, nurse, primary teachers, etc., whereas there are merely 10% in men's jobs like attorney, doctors, and engineering, and etc. So similar studies have been conducted in England also, and it has been found that 33.5% of British women population is either unemployed or underemployed, which proves that the men get priority in the jobs than women. So a sociological research has been conducted in Britain among the employers. That's why they prefer men, in which majority replied that since they take care of household and job simultaneously, they do not give their 100% in job. And second, they take frequent obligatory leaves than the males. And this proves that there are certain cultural prejudices regarding potentials and problems of women, even in the most modern societies. So basically, in US, a sociological investigation was conducted in which a question has been asked to the husbands, that what your wife is doing. Then majority replied that she is doing nothing, she is a housewife. So when same question was asked from wife, what are you doing, she replied, I have no leisure from early morning to the evening because I take care of household, and this proves that the job of woman is nothing in the eyes of men. So, but in the modern society, the relative status of women is fast changing. Feminism, economic activities, social legislations, legal safeguard, education and awareness has helped to challenge the old age patriarchal system worldwide. So now it has been established that if given an equal opportunity, women can do equally good like men. Then Edward Ellice, in her book Cult of True Womanhood, wrote that now the world has started giving space to women dignity, aspirations, and better chances for realizing their individual dreams. So now women can seek their identity beyond the identity of daughter, sister, mother, wife, etc., and they are become now entrepreneurs too, and there are a lot of things that they are doing. So, but still the gender equality is a myth. Only it is relatively better in one society than the others. But after the efforts of state, society and other modern institutions, the inequality opposed on the basis of gender is diminishing, and the hope is alive that one day society which give up all the prejudice of gender and a gender neutral society will be realized. So now we move to ethnicity and race. So basically, it is same. Race is a physiological phenomena in which, on the basis of certain biological characteristics, so basically in sex we say basically about reproductive organs biologically differentiate sex and gender, whereas in ethnicity, race is also a biological or physiological phenomena, but here the biological characteristics are different, and on this basis the individuals are classified, and the basis of biological characteristics like color of the skin, texture of hair, nose, eyes, lips, etc. There are four types of races, and these are Caucasians, that means white, Negrito means black, Proto-Australoid, and we have finally the fourth race is Mongoloid. So here race is a physiological phenomenon, whereas ethnicity is a socio-cultural expression of race, whereas gender is also a sociological cultural expression of sex. So for example, a single race, Caucasian, spread it worldwide from Germany and settled in different parts of the world. So why they migrated or spread it to different to the whole world? Because they are in the search of food, and ultimately they got settled in particular geographical conditions, and then they developed certain they adopted distinguished language, German languages, culture, food habits, clothing according to the new environment, and they hence become the ethnic groups. So hence Aryans, Britons, French, Russian, etc. are some of the ethnic groups which emerge out of Caucasian race. And why they are also able to spread? Because they have superior technology, weapons, and they have ensured the use of horses, which lead to success of whites and over the they have success of the whites, that is ethnic group of Caucasian race, over the blacks, who are basically all the ethnic groups which are emerged from Negrito and Proto-Australoid. So racial purity is a myth. Over the period, the different races have intermixed with each other, and hence a single race in its purest form cannot be identified. So in the history, on the basis of racial prejudices, white dominated and exploited the black for centuries on the basis of myth of racial superiority, and on the basis of white's man burden, whites believe that they have the natural right to rule the black because God has made them superior. In Europe, Africa and America, on the basis of racial prejudices, social structures were formed. So in US, when Britons and Europeans got settled, over the period they made blacks as slaves, and they were kept under the social exclusion for decades. Martin Luther King and Abraham Lincoln finally managed to end the regime of apartheid, and equal rights have been given to blacks, we can say legally and constitutionally, but still on the socio-economic and cultural dimensions, whites are far ahead than the blacks. For example, in courts, public offices, prisons, blacks are unequally treated than the whites. So then Samuel Stauffer in his book The American Soldiers and the Albert Cohen, his concept of the status frustration explained the conditions of black in the American society, and the per capita income of black is far less than the whites. Black lives in slums, small houses and filthy conditions, and in general believe that blacks are good for the manual jobs. Similarly, in Britain, for the same job, whites get better salary than the blacks. So blacks are given unequal treatment in terms of promotions, opportunities, facilities, etc. And blacks are considered as good for the jobs like construction, transportations and factories, and the jobs environment given to blacks is far inferior than the whites. So in South Africa, before the end of apartheid, whites used to treat blacks in very inhumane manner, and on the stations, parks, trains, restaurants, the blacks have different seating arrangement. Certain roads, hospitals, restaurants, markets were only meant to be used by the whites. So they were not given democratic and voting rights. They were not allowed to take up white collar jobs, and in all the racial prejudiced societies, ethnic stigmas were put over them, which was derogatory, inhumane, against the dignity of that group. So against this ethnic inequality, various social reforms like Martin Luther King and Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, etc. took the initiative and launched social movement, and finally or legally it has been abolished perhaps in all societies, but in practical senses the ethnic equality is still far from the reality, and different states and international bodies are trying hard to abolish it. So thank you guys for listening me and watching this video. Thank you.